Church in Yale. To those present here at the Top Chapel, and those joining us via Zoom, today is the third Sunday of Advent, what is known as Gaudete Sunday, taken from the Latin, first word in Latin of the text of the day, Gaudete, which means rejoice. And today's service is dedicated to praise in music, led by our choir director, Michael Lucan, our choir, and this wonderful orchestra that we'll be leading today. The service will be very different today, with no sermon. Okay, you can all shed a tear. From me this week, but lots of good music. We'll begin in the 18th century with movements from Mozart's Musica in G major, and we'll conclude with Cantata Pax, a major anthem written by British composer Gerald Finzi in 1954. You'll see Michael's recital notes on the back of your bulletin. I urge you to look at those, as well as the folder introducing you to some of our choir members. Drawing on the Finzi anthem, we decided that the theme for this Advent service is In Terra Pax, On Earth Peace. In between movements, you'll hear readings about peace, and Pastor Jenny will lead prayers on earth for peace today. And I want to sort of set your mind as you think about listening to this music. Of course, just listen to it, it's beautiful. But if you want to be thinking in a worshipful way, our thoughts might turn during the Mass or the Misa Brevis to our Holy Communion service, which we haven't experienced this semester. We know the ancient progression of that service, from confession to glorifying God for forgiveness, to the holiness of God at consecration, and finally to singing about Jesus as the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. We invite you to remember that Eucharistic flow as you listen. Take, bless, break, and give. As we celebrate the music, what we can't celebrate at the table right now. And as you listen towards the end of the service to the In Terra Pax, I was wondering about, does the music capture that feeling that I think we all get in the Christmas season sometime, about how Christmas 21 feels directly connected to that first Christmas. And I think you'll see that in the poetry of this beautiful piece. How does Christmas 21 connect to the first Christmas? And now we'll begin worship with a call to worship and the great Advent hymn drawn from Isaiah 40, Comfort, comfort you, my people, calling on God to comfort the oppressed people. And then Tony and Michael will be our music, and Tony and Michael will be our community. So if you can stand as you wish, and join me in call to worship. It is a day for voices and instruments.
For the praise of God in melody and harmony.
In ancient and modern verse,
the story of Christ is told there.
His birth, his life, his passion,
his love and peace.
He was first announced in song by angels.
Let us worship in music again.
And I invite you to remain standing at home and listen as the choir sings our first hymn.
Thank you. Today, we light the third candle of the Advent wreath. We've lit the candles of hope and love the last two Sundays. Today, we light the candle of peace. In the Christmas story in Luke's Gospel, the heavenly host, the whole heavenly chorus of saints and angels join in singing, "On earth, peace, goodwill to all." The prophets write about how the normal rules of conflict and violence in this world will be overturned by the Messiah's coming. The lion will lie down with the lamb, swords will be melted and molded into plowshares. The Christmas story is a story of peace. After a short litany, we will light the candle, and then you're invited to come along as the choir sings the first verse of "O Come, O Come, Emmanuel."
As our Advent journey continues, we light a candle for peace.
We look at our world and see all the places where there is conflict and violence.
We look inside and feel our own inner turmoil, the lack of peace in our own hearts.
Do I believe in the Prince of Peace? Can I find peace within and peace with others?
As we light our candle, we seek a peace that is more than just the absence of conflict.
We seek the peace that only Christ can give, the peace of love and acceptance of ourselves and others.
Come, O come, Emmanuel.
Peace of Christ be with you always. In the spirit of today and this season, I invite you to stand and share the peace of Christ with one another. You might wave, bump elbows, introduce yourself, or share a sign of peace with each other. And for those on Zoom, please say hello and share Christ's peace in the chat. Peace be with you.
Sing aloud, O daughter Zion. Shout, O Israel. Rejoice and exult with all your heart, O daughter of Jerusalem. The Lord has taken away the judgments against you. He has turned away your enemies. The King of Israel, the Lord, is in your midst. You shall fear disaster no more. On that day it shall be said to Jerusalem, do not fear, O Zion. Do not let your hands grow weak. The Lord your God is in your midst, a warrior who gives victory. He will rejoice over you with gladness. He will renew you in his love. He will exult over you with loud singing, as on the day of festival. I will remove disaster from you, so that you will not fear reproach for it. I will deal with all your oppressors at that time, and I will save the lame and gather the outcast, and I will change their shame into praise and renown in all of the earth. At that time I will bring you home, at that time when I gather you, for I will make you renowned and praised among all the peoples of the earth, when I restore your fortunes before your eyes, says the Lord. This is the word of God for the people of God.
Thank you. Thank you.
A reading from Henry Nouwen. Did I offer peace today? Did I bring a smile to someone's face? Did I say words of healing? Did I let go of my anger and resentment? Did I forgive? Did I love? These are the real questions. I must trust that the little bit of love that I sow now will bear many fruits here in this world and the life to come.
Thank you.
Spirit, whom the Father will send in my name, will teach you everything, and remind you of all that I have said to you. Peace I leave with you, my peace I give to you. I do not give to you as the world gives. Do not let your hearts be troubled, and do not let them be afraid. This is the good news of the gospel.
Praise to you, Christ.
King is born in a stable. Even a lack of hospitality, no room at the inn, could not prevent Christ from coming. A star shined in the sky, and wise sojourners were led through the darkness of many nights. Shepherds busy at work in the fields were met by the miraculous, an angel of the Lord bringing them good tidings, and a choir of angels singing out in ways that we can only but glimpse in the incredible sounds that captivate us here on earth announcing Christ coming. And suddenly Christ came. And though much might have seemed the same, nothing was the same. In Terra Pax, the work that we are about to hear from the choir and orchestra tells this story. We hear the narrator, who could be thought of as Finzi, the composer, telling the story of Christmas, alongside his own experiences of Christmas in England on a frosty night as he heard a church bell ring out. Finzi, Michael's program notes tells us, had experienced more tragedy and loss than many of our lives are meant to hold. And yet, in his music, he connected listeners to a sense of deep hope and peace. Before we listen to Finzi's work, we're going to enter into a time of prayer together, when we can remember and seek Christ's peace as individuals and as a community. When you came in, you were given a piece of paper with two sides on it. Now's the time to pull that out. I know we ran out of bulletins, I'm so sorry about that. So for some of you, you can take notes on your phone, you can make notes on your phone, or on any paper that you have with you. On one side of the paper, it says, "Peace I found." And on the other side, it says, "Peace I'm seeking." On the side that says, "Peace I found," you're invited to prayerfully reflect on where you have found a sense of God's peace lately. It may have been in still, quiet moments in nature maybe, or it may have been in a large moment, and a shift of understanding or relationship that has brought you peace. Whatever it may be, you're invited to reflect in prayer and write, if you wish, about the peace you have found or are finding. And then, on the other side, you're invited to pray for the ways that you are longing for a sense of peace. Peace in your life, peace from chronic pain, peace in a relationship, or a desire for self-understanding, peace about something that has been troubling you, or peace for the places in our world that are aching for a lasting peace. Not the world's version of peace, which follows war, but God's peace, which casts out fear and is endless. Again, if you don't have a piece of paper, the prompts are, "Peace I am seeking," and "Peace I have found." And you'll keep these prayers with you. Does anyone need a pen? Feel free to raise your hand. All right, looks like we're good. Let us pray. We'll have a moment of silence as we write and pray. For what do we give God thanks? Where have we found peace? And for what do we long for peace? What do we bring to Christ seeking his lasting goodness? Let us pray. continue in prayer, and you're welcome to continue writing the prayer, praying on your own as well. Wonderful Counselor, Prince of Peace, our Alpha and Omega, beginning and end. Your ways are not our ways. Your goodness isn't brought by our hard work or bargaining. You come as your Son came, in small moments where nothing is no longer the same. We give thanks, loving God, for the ways that you have met us in the midst of the world's chaotic times. Thank you for helping us to slow down, to look up, be alert to your glad tidings, and to see the gifts you have shared so generously all around us. Gifts of friendship and inspiration, gifts of beauty and understanding, gifts of peace. Intercede on our behalf, O God, where there is violence, turn swords into plowshares. Where there is loneliness, bring connection. Where we feel lost, reveal to us the next step on our path. Where there is anxiety, quiet our fear, and help us to trust in that which is beyond our control. You meet us in ordinary people in our ordinary lives, and you share your extraordinary grace and presence, O God. Meet us now as we tell the Christmas story again. Meet us in this season of Advent as we honor the time before you came, as we remember the moment when you did come, and as we look to the moments when you are coming still. Amen. And now, joining together, let us say the ancient words that still speak and allow us to speak to God. The Lord's Prayer, in whatever language or translation is closest to your heart. Our God, Lord, and hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory. Before Interfox begins, the ensemble will prepare to play. And please note that we have had a slight error in printing. And for those who have the regular print, you'll see Interfox here. And then this page is meant to be flipped. So instead of a hymn, if you turn the page, you'll notice the rest of Interfox. And then we'll have our final reading of the day, and then we'll turn back to see the hymn. So just don't be surprised when the choir moves directly into the hymn. Thank you. Let us prepare to listen.
child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His authority shall grow continually, and there shall be endless peace. This is the word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. Now, friends, please rise in body or in spirit for the hymn which is found on your previous page.
Service on the 24th, 25th, and 26th. I'll be back for a joint service at First and Summerfield.
Methodist Church on January 2nd. But do come next week for the fourth Sunday. And now, please join me for the words of our benediction. Prophet Micah, with what shall I come before the Lord?
And bow myself before God.
God has told you, O mortal, what is good.
And what does the Lord require of me?
But to do justice.
To do justice.
And to love kindness.
To love kindness.
Walk humbly with your God.
To walk humbly with our God.
Go forth now in peace, in the name of the God who made you, who saves you, who sends you out. Amen.
I'm looking for you.